वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ बॉलीवुड दिस वीक। फ्रेंड्स, द मूवी वी शो गोइंग रिव्यू टुडे इज विजय'स मूवी भैरवा। वेल फ्रेंड्स, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस रिव्यू आई जस्ट वांट टू मेक वन थिंग क्लियर दैट नो क्रिटिक ऑन द प्लैनेट अर्थ इज यू नो क्वालिफाइड एंड केपेबल टू रिव्यू द मूवी स्टारिंग विजय तलपति विजय, बिकॉज व्हेन द सॉन्ग कम्स इन All hell breaks loose in the cinema hall, and trust me friends, after that 2 hours 49 minutes you won't even think what's happening on screen. And even if Vijay, instead of serving chicken tandoori, gives you, you know, just tandoori roti, you won't complain, because Talapathy Vijay has made a mark in Tamil film industry that his fan following is insane. And with Bhairava, he has made Bhairava specifically for his mass audiences, not the class audiences. And Bhairava for the mass audiences is a delight to watch. I enjoyed myself. If the film was stopped at the interval, trust me, it would have been a bumper hit. After interval, things go a little wary, but in the climax, Vijay pulls it back amazingly and fantastically, and that is what is the highlight of Bhairava. And the soundtrack, I've just watched the movie and come back, and Bhairava, it's been on the loop and I've heard it about 30-35 times. Cracking song. This BGM is enough for you to go and watch Bhairava if you are lucky enough to get tickets, because it's a bumper hit, friends. So friends, let us review Vijay's movie Bhairava. Bhairava has been directed by Bharathanam. A lot of confusion in pronouncing his name. His name is Bharathan, and the music has been given by Santosh Narayan. Sadly, apart from Wala Wala Ma and Papa Papa, not all songs, you know, live up to the expectation, but it's a quite decent track. The editing of this movie is done by Praveen KC. Writing, screenplay and direction is done by Bharathan. The film stars obviously Talapathy Vijay. We have Kirti Suresh. Kirti Suresh is a surprise in this movie. She's extremely gorgeous, extremely charming, and fills in, you know, with the movie with her beauty and glamour. Jagapati Babu plays the villain PK. We have Daniel Balaji, who plays Jagapati Babu's right hand. We have Aparna Virod, who plays, you know, the heroine Kirti Suresh's friend. We have Satish, who obviously the Kati guy with Vijay, as again in the movie plays Shanmugam. We have Thambi Ramaya in this movie. And we also have Mr. Motte Rajendran in this movie, who is absolutely hilarious. So what is Bhairava all about? Why is it so good that people can't believe it and are terming it as bad movie? Well friends, let me tell you, there is enough for you to enjoy this movie. So friends, let me start with the review of the movie Bhairava. Bhairava is a story of Vijay, who works for a bank. This bank, you know, deals in giving loans to people, but unfortunately the loans are not returned to them. And Vijay plays a collecting agent. He goes and collects money from people who have not paid the loan. Well, one day the manager calls Vijay and narrates his sad story that a bunch of goons in Chennai, who also known as a cricket gang, called him, you know, to sign the papers, took the money and gave an empty bag, and instead told him to play cricket with them and hit them with a cork ball. Well, there's a very sad scene in the starting, friends. The manager has been hit by the cork balls, and you know, the villains are super deadly. Talapathy Vijay, red color bike, fantastic. I mean, what an entry, man. Walla walla ma, Vijay on the bike, you know, enters in and he's wearing a tie. That scene is enough for you to go and watch Bhairava. You can come out after that. Seriously speaking, Vijay tells him, I want to play cricket with you guys. First, he, you know, plays the Sachin drive. Then he gives the Kohli look. Then he plays like Ricky Ponting, Sehwag, all photos side by side. And in the end, he hits the helicopter Dhoni shot, and all these balls which he hits goes and, you know, hits on the head or on the, you know, private part of the people. And it's a fantastic scene, friends, trust me. And a song which follows that, the mass number where Satish and, you know, Vijay dance, is absolutely kick-ass. Till then, the whole theater has been filled with boom, boom, fire balloons. And if you are going for a fan show, God bless you, friends, because you're not going to hear a single dialogue. The fans just enjoyed the movie, and it is a very enjoyable movie. So Talapati Vijay comes back home, and his manager comes to his house to invite him for a daughter's wedding. But there is another guest who has to be invited for the wedding, and that is our heroine Kirti Suresh. Kirti Suresh, when she comes for the marriage, the car breaks down and something happens. Then Vijay's manager tells Vijay to go and get her to the wedding. He goes there and, you know, falls in love with Kirti Suresh, you know, and that's when the story starts. And let me tell you, friends, the song in the wedding, Vijay has danced beautifully. This guy acts from his heart. You know, I don't know why people tell this guy doesn't know acting. He is a natural born actor, and the steps in the wedding song is absolutely fantastic. So friends, the story moves forward. Vijay has fallen, you know, head over heels. The marriage got over. He calls up, you know, the manager's daughter and tells, where is the girl who came for the wedding yesterday? Well, Vijay goes and follows her with a bunch of red roses, and she is seen meeting a union minister's son. As soon as she goes to meet the union minister's son, the union minister's son comes in a huge car and gives her a bunch of flowers. Some gang members come and cut the hand of the union minister's son. That's when the story takes an ugly turn. Kirti Suresh runs to the bus stand, and the union minister comes and tries to kill Kirti Suresh. That's when a phone call comes from Jagapati Babu, and Kirti Suresh has been saved. Vijay goes to Kirti Suresh and tells her, what the hell is happening? You have to tell me what is happening. Well, a long flashback, and this is enough for Bhairava to be a hit at the box office. Well, friends, not many of you people know that what happens in medical colleges. It's a sad story which happens in India. There is a, you know, a structure built up and a board put up that it is a medical college. 40 to 45 lakh rupees seats for an MBBS student. Even if you get merit seat, you know, they don't give you government seat, and you have to pay donation by taking loans. And you know, it is impossible, you know, to get a seat in the government colleges. Well, friends, now story moves forward. Kirti Suresh is an MBBS aspiree and wants to join the medical course. Well, friends, she, you know, somehow managed to get, you know, admission into PK group of colleges, which is owned by Jagapati Babu. The college inside is just empty. There are no lectures. The OP department, the patient department is empty. Where are the students going to learn? The hostel facilities are so bad. Well, so Aparna Vinod, the another heroine of this movie, and Kirti Suresh together plan to file a case against the college. That's when Jagapati Babu comes to know of this, and MCI officials come to, you know, investigate what is happening in the college. During the inspection, MCI means Medical Council of India, if you don't, people don't know it. Well, they come and they find out that, you know, they have called people from engineering college, and their guys are wearing a stethoscope and they're roaming in the college, you know. They ask them, you know, check the pulse, and he takes out, you know, and checks out the heartbeat. And then he tells that, you know, he's the engineering professor. Very good scene, friends. This shows, you know, the plight of colleges in India, which, you know, give fake degrees and fake certificates. Well, then the MCI official go and ban Jagapati Babu and tell that whatever you are doing is wrong, and we are going to cancel license of the college. Jagapati Babu comes to know that these MCI officials are behind women. They like women, they want to sleep with women, especially the college students. So Jagapati Babu sends admission forms to them, and they select Kirti Suresh for spending one night with them. Daniel Balaji goes to the hostel warden, and the warden goes to, you know, Kirti Suresh's room and tells they need blood urgently. But Kirti Suresh tells that her blood group is different from the other blood group. Well, friends, that's when the story takes a turn, and Aparna Vinod has been kidnapped. Literally, you know, she goes by her own will, but she doesn't know that she's going to give blood, but going to spend a night with the MCI officials. They have sex, and then the next day she is found dead, friends, and only witness left is Kirti Suresh. So this is the backstory of this. What happens after that? Is Vijay, you know, able to capture Jagapati Babu? Is Kirti Suresh being saved? What does Jagapati Babu do? We all have to see that after the interval. But before the interval, when you are completely stuck to your seat, Vijay has a fight sequence where he tells that the private part also cannot touch me over here. Tunnu. Excellent dialogue, Fabulous, and you know, during the fight when he gives the rose to Kirti Suresh, that scene is the highlight. He challenges Jagapati Babu, and after interval, if you think the film is going to get boring, this is your wrong conception. After interval, this guy becomes, you know, a income tax officer and goes to Jagapati Babu's house. Raid has been conducted. Why? Because Union Minister's son had given a small pen drive having evidence against Jagapati Babu to Kirti Suresh that Jagapati Babu has taken. Well, he goes to the house, fantastic scene, friends. Vijay, as the, you know, CBI officer who goes for a raid, you know, income tax officer, he breaks the gas cylinder and gets the pen drive. Well, Jagapati Babu comes to know that he's not a CBI officer. Court goes into, the case goes into the court, and Kirti Suresh's lawyer has been, you know, manhandled by Jagapati Babu. His wife has been told in Canada not to tell his husband to fight this case. No lawyer, nothing. No papers, no evidence. Talapati Vijay gives the speech of his life in the court that why this case should be fought, and that's when the audience is, you know, arises again and Vijay steps in. Well, after that, you know, court has given some time to Vijay and his, you know, friends to fight this case again in court. After that, the film goes really fast. Seriously speaking, the Papa Papa song ends, and in the end, how does Vijay, you know, try to, you know, capture Jagapati Babu? There are black cop commandos and an excellent fight again. Walla walla ma, walla walla ma, Bairava comes in. I won't tell what happens in the end, but end is fantastic. So why are people telling that Bairava is so bad? Well, yes, friends, the film is not up to the mark of 2016-17 standards. It is quite an old story, but the background music and Vijay makes this a watchable, not even watchable, a very entertaining affair. If you are not a Vijay fan or you are against Vijay, then friends, you will find many faults in this film. But if you are a Vijay fan and you love Vijay, this is an unmissable movie. I give Bhairava 1, 2, 3, 4 stars. It's strictly for Vijay fans, and no critic is capable of reviewing Bhairava. So friends, keep watching Bollywood This Week, like and subscribe to our channel.